If you're watching this video, you have stumbled across somebody figuring themselves out a little bit. My name's Christina. I'm a professional makeup artist. I have not had any coffee this morning. I'm a coffee addict, so that's a problem. Today, I'm starting a new part of my life. I'm going to start making videos. The reason why I chose Patreon is for convenience, mainly. I know a lot about it. I know how it works. By the way, sorry if the configuration's weird. I'm still figuring it out. On my iPad, my laptop does not have a good webcam. We'll figure it out. We'll get good at it. So today is going to be date night. Makeup. My cat is over here making noise if you hear that. It's real. We're not editing anything ever. So what I think about when I think of date night is kind of an interesting story because I've been married since January. I dated online. We mainly did video calls through Zoom. And, I mean, I had a year of dating online. So I have a year of makeup looks. I'm sorry about my cat. I'm sure you can hear that. So this is going to be number one. I did a good mix, all right? So this is going to be more on the natural end. You're going to see it. You're going to love it. That's perfect for date night. If you're going like, I always imagine what I'm doing, or I would, I was doing these looks like, we're going to go on a picnic, or we're going to, you know, go to the movies, or to a fancy dinner. We never really got to do a lot of that because he lived in Tennessee at the time. I lived up in Ohio. Now that we're married, though, we do. Very nice, but it was a while before I really got to date my husband. So first step, I have my skin prepped, my eyes primed, everything is ready to go. Mm-hmm. Got acne because hormones. So the first step that we're going to do, we're going to start with the eyes. So makeup artists will come for me, but I have a reason. When I started doing my makeup 10 years ago, more than 10 years, probably closer to 15. Now I'm 25 today. People started with their eyes. Always started with their eyes. So I'm starting with my eyes. Start with whatever you want, okay? There's no rules to makeup. This is just a guide. A generalized guide to help you through the day. So we're going to start off with this Morphe Eyeless Shadow Stick and Sharpener. Where's my camera? It's over here. It's kind of this nice dusty pink color. What is the color called? It's called Upon a Star. I like that. So my camera's right here. My mirror is right here. So if at any time it looks weird, we're still figuring it out, and I appreciate your patience. So I'm just going to all over the lid. Now a color like this is good, in my opinion, for a variety of skin tones. And the reason that I say in my opinion is because everybody is going to think a little bit different, and that's fine. But light pinks, mauves, those kinds of colors flatter most people. If hazel green eyes, you can't really tell on the camera. This color is going to make the green pop. It also works well for blue eyes. Brown eyes, pretty much every eye color. I'm just going to tap it in with my finger. It's very emollient, but it doesn't really transfer off. I love this. It's very quick, very easy, single eyeshadow kind of look if that's what you're going for. We're not going for that today per se, but yeah. Looks brand new because it is brand new. I just used it for the first time today, but I love that formula. I'm just, like, lighting is weird, isn't it? iPad. Yeah, it's pretty much like my skin tone, I think. But, and even in my mirror, it looks pretty much like my skin tone. Nice wash of color, very light. I'm sure that you could go deeper. That's all I want to do. I'm going, I'm all about preservation and ease. I'm going to set it with my Essence Skin Perfector Loose Perfecting. My Skin Perfector Loose Fixing Powder. Can't talk. It has an instant blur effect, natural matte finish. Since that's a matte eyeshadow stick, I don't mind using a matte setting powder for it. I'm just going to use like an eyeshadow brush. Any will do. I've had this for 10 years or so. Just dust it all over the lid. Now, my style of makeup is usually easy, comfortable. My sense of style in general is easy and comfortable. I'm wearing jeans for the first time in a few days today. So y'all should be feeling privileged with that information, okay? I'm sure you do. I'm sure you feel overjoyed. You don't have to. Alright, so next we're going to use the MAC Bare to the Max palette. Now, it was backwards for you. I'm sure that it's going to look better. We're only going to use two shades. I was only going to use one, but I think two. Ah, sorry. I'm very good at this. I'm a professional. Alright, so we're going to use this lightest shade and this very, very lightly warmer brown. And then with that same brush first, I'm going to go in with the warmer brown. I just want to warm up the crease just a little bit. You don't have to do this. I have very round eyes. I like to emphasize that shape a little bit. You don't have to. If you don't feel like it, this step is purely optional. I'm actually going to lie and dip into the skin tone shade right there. My skin tone shade. Right there, just to blend out the edges because I want a little crazy above the brows. And anything that we mess up on, we can clean up with foundation or concealer later. Pardon me. Morning voice a little bit. Coffee time. Yes. Alright, next we're going to go in with that light shimmery shade. I'm just going to use my fingertip. Tap in there gently. Press it onto the probably like close to the inner third of the eye and then blend out gently from there. See? Yep. You definitely cannot see that. It's not so bad. Now, doing it like this instead of just highlighting the inner corner is going to make your eyes look brighter. Most people will tend to gravitate toward just the inner corner. That's fine. Do it that way if that's how you like to do it. However, it just makes your eyes look brighter, like makes you look more awake. I like looking awake. I have been up since, I've already been up for almost 2 hours. It's early in the morning. I'm looking for a brush. Pardon me. I'm looking for a brush while looking at you. It's called talent. Got a brush? That's an eyeliner. Good. That's what I wanted. We're looking for something. I am very much prepared this morning. All right, so it's been a week. It's only Wednesday, and it's been a week. Okay, long week. It's about over. Thank goodness. I'm going to smoke out the lower lash line just a little bit with that brown. Perfect. I'm using a teeny tiny little brush. I like using these small brushes for this kind of step because it's easier to control. So then I just start from the outer corner, blending my way in. I buff it in with my fingertip. And the reason why I use my fingertip instead of another brush is because it's just easier that way. Like, gives it a more softer, diffused look. Being in the makeup world, you kind of figure out your own methods that most people aren't going to use, right? And you'll learn that I am a beast of my own breed today, if you haven't already. So that's it for the eyeshadow. I don't mess with a lot of eyeshadow anyway. And then we're going to do eyeliner. This is the Araceli. Oh, we're not going to try that. Juju. Ta-da! Fancy eyeliner. Just a felt tip. Nothing special. I'm just going to lightly line the top lid. Hang it out just a very little bit. Yep. Do the same thing on the other side. I think this look kind of lends its hand to being like you can go so many different ways with it. You can make it a little bit more dramatic if you want, like deepen up the crease, add a little bit more of a wing, like I'm doing right now. I feel like I need more wing, just a little bit. You can add false eyelashes or anything. The kind of makeup I do is very simple, right? You can customize it. Because I customize it all the time, actually. The sides are not even. Pretty good. You didn't see that change? I did. Okay, so now we're going to tight line with the MAC Graphblack Technakohl Eyeliner. Came in a kit. Just go a little bit on the bottom. See, I don't go all the way. The goal with this kind of makeup look is to make my eyes look bright, wide, awake, like I've had so much espresso that I can't actually think properly. Ta-da! It works pretty good, I think. Now we're going to skip the mascara for a second. This is another thing that I kind of do that's a little bit off. I go to the face products before my mascara. And I don't have a good reason for that, except that's just how I do. Okay? There it is. Now we're going to go in with foundation now. We're going to use the Naked Weightless Liquid Foundation up to 24 hour wear. I haven't worn this in forever, but I'm going to wear foundation. It's going to be like super light. The heavier the foundation, the harder it is on your skin, in my opinion. Like, just it looks heavy, isn't forgiving. Lighter foundations tend to lend its hand to looking more like your own face while still providing a little bit of coverage. I am a firm believer in a lighter coverage foundation and a heavier coverage concealer. Due to the fact that, generally speaking, concealers are made for that, foundation is not. Foundation is more for an evening, and a concealer is more for concealing. So, this is going to be a thing. My favorite brush is Massive. It's my foundation brush. It's a powder kabuki thing. But, I find that it just blends the best. I just tap it into my skin, and it... I don't know, it works magical. I've used so many sponges, so many different brushes. This is the only one that I've ever used where it's like, gosh, that looks just like my own skin. Every time, without fail, it looks like my face, but better because it's just blended and so nice. And it's so quick, it doesn't take long at all. It doesn't tend to emphasize problem areas using a brush like this, especially in combination with the Naked Foundation from Urban Decay. Now, as you can see, that's not the fullest coverage. You can still see my friend right there. I'm okay with that. I'm not going to mess with it. If you would want to cover it up, feel free. Right? There's why I don't, because I kind of like the natural skin. My nose is... You can't see it in the camera, but my nose did not blend out very good today. My nose is my problem area. We fight a lot. We're not always on talking terms. You can kind of see that. Next, I'm going to use the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Wear Concealer. This is in the shade Fawn, because I'm pale. I'm a Fawn. A pale Fawn. Looks like I'm doing it for the lifted effect, but I've been doing my concealer like this my whole life. I don't like wearing a lot of it. I'm not trying to do the effect of, like, lifted. I don't find that it works myself. I do find that it looks more natural, though. So I do tend to gravitate toward doing my concealer this way, because it just looks more like your skin. Highlighting the points that need highlighted. I don't have the darkest of circles, but if they're gonna shine through, I'm not gonna complain. Again, my hair is coming out, so we better get this party started. I like looking natural. I like looking like myself. I don't wear makeup to cover anything, like, dramatically, right? Some people think that's weird. Do you? If you wanna paint it on, paint it on. You're following my tutorial, okay? This is my decisions. No, do it your way. Do it your way. Alright. That L'Oreal concealer does lend itself to drying a little bit quick on me. But I think I got it okay. I think we're good. My cat is just going, All right, we're looking good. I'm happy with the way my skin looks right now. Next, we're gonna go in with powder. I like to use the CoverGirl Clean Matte Pressed Powder. I use pressed powders in general. It goes between this and the e.l.f. Camo powder foundation. I'm not feeling like I need that much extra coverage though. I'm just gonna use the CoverGirl one. The CoverGirl one has a lot less coverage, but it lends itself to looking very natural. Very, like, you don't need to worry about it looking, like, cakey. This one doesn't look cakey either, the e.l.f. one, but it tends to feel a little bit heavier. I use a sponge, like this. And what I tend to do is just smush it in there, get a ton of product on there, and then just go to town. T-zone first. Now, I have very oily skin. We're talking BP's jealous, okay? Not BP. Is it BP? I don't know. Gas stations in general right now are jealous, okay? They want my skin because it's always oily. It's always producing. As you can see, I go in a little heavy-handed. It's probably a me thing. I feel like it helps cover a multitude of sins, you see. If you make a mistake, having a little bit of extra powder to kind of set everything in place. If you're oily skin, if you're dry skin, don't do this. I don't want to be responsible for your skin getting very dry looking and stuff. You know, if you're dry skin, my recommendation is to use an even more hydrating foundation than this. I feel like the Stay Naked is more on the hydrating side, at least for me. Again, oily skin. If you're oily and you like the more hydrating feeling foundations, the Stay Naked is a good one. It is probably my favorite foundation I've ever used. It lends itself to being very lightweight, very comfortable on the skin. You don't feel it at all. I don't hardly feel it on my skin, and I just powdered it and everything. Okay. Next, we're gonna do bronzer. Now, I don't believe in contouring. Fun fact, contouring never looks natural. Ever. Okay? And the reason why it doesn't is because your face is built a certain way. You should enhance that shape, not try to hide it. Yeah? My cat's screaming at me. So I'm going to use the Butter Bronzer, the original shade from Physician's Formula, and I'm using a big fluffy brush. I think this is from EcoTools. Yep. It's a full powder brush. I just kind of gently tap and roll. And I start at the hollows of my cheeks, kind of like in a contouring method. But I'm not actually contouring. Gazpacho, no. Gazpacho. It's my cat's name. He's a menace to society. I'm gonna have to ignore that. Don't you dare put your face in my coffee, young man. You need to get over here. Yep, I'm just going all over my face, pretty much. It's almost like I am contouring, but there's so little on the brush that it's very much subtle. I go across my nose and cheeks, kind of like I'm putting blush on. It just makes your skin look very naturally sun-kissed. Yeah, you can't hardly see it on this camera. I'm gonna have to figure this out. But it works really good. If you want to diffuse any powders, the bigger the and lighter, you want it to be super fluffy, get a lot of give. That is the best way to get the most subtle appearance of. Sir, you're gonna knock over my glasses. I wear glasses because I'm blind. And my cat's gonna knock them over. That's how you get the most subtle effect. Alright, now we're gonna go into blush. I'm going to use the Dallas by Benefit. I don't much care for this blush, but my other one got destroyed in the washer. So I'm just gonna be light-handed again. I'm just gonna use another fluffier brush. I could easily go in with the brush I just used, but I'm just gonna use this one because it's a little bit flatter. I don't remember where I got this brush. A lot of these I've had for years. I do like to do the nose a little bit, just the tip. That's what she said. Anyway, then highlight. I don't tend to highlight my face too much. If I do, I tend to gravitate towards the more natural highlights. Can't find the one that I'm thinking of. My makeup is a disaster, guys. Pray for me. Pray for my husband. Pray for my family. Dishonor on my cow. All that good stuff. Right. Well, where are you going, little nugget? Y'all, I swear. 2022 has been an interesting roller coaster. How has it been for you? I want to know. We're going to use the Laura Geller Baked Highlighter in Golden Rose. I love this highlighter. If I'm going to use one, it's going to be one like that. Little brush, and the reason why is because I get more control. Don't want a huge bit of highlighter on my face. The more subtle, the better. The more natural it'll look. I don't like to put it on my temples. I will, however, put it under my brows, just like that. Highlight the nose. And you're not getting into my makeup for a reason, sir. It's not for you. You're too young. This is him, the menace. Isn't he cute? I'll get down. Go away. So powder is done. Hi. We're gonna set the face with the Maybelline Lasting Fix makeup setting spray. I just drench my face. Oh, I missed a spot. The thing we're doing. Some coffee. We do let it dry for a minute. Setting spray is like a magical thing, right? I love it because it just makes everything look and make more sense. This is way better. I look exhausted because I am. Alright, next step, we're gonna go into the eyebrows. My eyebrows are naturally very full, so I don't tend to do much. I usually just use eyebrow gel. I'm gonna use the Tarte Busy Gal Brow in Ash Blonde. Not my favorite. Came in another kit. It does the job. Makes them look good. love my eyebrow shape. I have worked so many, many hours of my young adult life trying to make my brows this shape. And here we are. Nice and rounded, nice and soft. My cat is over here grunting at birds outside. It's great. It really is. I love it. My cat's so weird. Next is going to be mascara. Mascara is one of those things where a lot of people are here and there about it, but I love mascara. I will wear it by itself with no other products and feel totally beautiful. I feel like without mascara, my look is never complete. One of my favorites is the L'Oreal Voluminous Original. I have long but thin eyelashes because I'm a natural blonde. I don't curl my eyelashes with a curler because I've never had much luck with them. If you have one that you like, go ahead and recommend it to me. They always pull out so many of my eyelashes. It's focus time, friends. You can't go wrong. It's a classic mascara for a reason. I'm just trying to show you guys. Sorry, that was weird. Right, to the next eye. I do have the waterproof version of this as well, and that is just as good. I don't feel like I generally need the waterproof mascara version. Unless, like I wore it on my wedding day because of tears, obviously. I would wear it when I worked at Walmart. If you want to hear Walmart stories, by the way, we can do a makeup in Walmart series. You need to let me know. Okay? If I have it right, I should be able to put the Discord that I created for this in a description of some sort. I have not checked that out. Oh my god, I put mascara on my hair and then on my forehead. That is the best part about wearing light makeup, y'all. I'm gonna be able to take my little sponge, put some powder, put it right there. Looks like it never happened. Which I'll do here in a minute. Then I just go underneath my eyes. Same mascara. Don't need nothing special. My eyes are not super sensitive and watery. If you're gonna do this, I recommend using the waterproof. This stuff. It's definitely not waterproof. I'm just gonna go in and touch up my inner lashes real quick. Twisty. Twisty. And we're good. Alright. Perfect. Now I'm going to cover that little spot up. Wherever that sponge may be. There it is. So, I use sponges. I don't use brushes for my face powder. I'm a little bit backwards. It's fine. Gazpacho, I know. I know, gazpacho, there's birds. He's going away now, I think. Goodbye. I love my cat. I do. So, ta-da! Fixed. Next and final is lips. Alright. I hope that you like the look that I've come up with. This is something that I used to do a lot on date night. Here it is. I'm going to use as lip liner and lipstick. The Essence Stay 8-Hour Lip Liner, waterproof the sharpener. Where's the shade? It's called Keep Receipts, is the shade. I wore this on my wedding day. It's my favorite one. I don't overline my lips. There's nothing wrong with it. It just does not look right on my face. And voila. You can top that with a gloss, a liquid lipstick. I like the lip liner as it is. Alright, let's pick this thing up real quick. And that's the look that you just created. Good job. It's beautiful. I hope you liked this video. If you did, make sure to follow my Patreon. My Instagram, Facebook page, it's all Lofritz Beauty or Lofritz Beauty Consulting. Okay, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next week. Goodbye.